So basically, this movie is a prime example of just because you can doesn't mean you should. Gemini Man is directed by Ang Lee and stars Will Smith, Mary Elizabeth Winstead, Clive Owen, and Benedict Wong. And it tells a story that we've seen a thousand times before in a thousand other action movies about an aging hitman who is deemed as a liability to the company he works for, and they send someone out to eliminate him. In this case, the someone they send is a younger, cloned version of himself, Gemini Man. So guys, I'm shooting in my office because I've been working late all week. Every time I think to myself, I'm gonna go home and I'm gonna shoot this and get this review out, I'm just not getting the time. So I decided to just stay back. I'm after work, of course, and just get this video out using my phone. So I hope it looks okay. Bear with me, but I just want to get this out before it's too late and the week has already ran out. We've already have three new movies coming out probably today: Maleficent, Zombieland, and The Informer. What else is there to say about this movie? I mean, you've probably seen the reviews on it already. This movie, for me, I give them points for the attempt. I'll do that. Because I think if this movie came out maybe 10 years ago, before we even experienced de-aging technology in like Marvel movies and even other films, Pirates of the Caribbean, whatever, you know, we would have might have been more impressed with it. The visuals, okay, I'll say this, like there are some parts where it works really well. Like there are scenes of Will's face where you know, the tears look real. And I guess it's him, you know, it's him using mocap technology or whatever, coupled with however they do this. But you know, the tears look real, his eyes are getting red, you can see the pores on his face, you can see the hair follicles properly, and it looks really good in some scenes. Like you could tell they put a lot of effort into some of these scenes over others. And by over others, I mean nearly everything else, because there's like one strong action sequence in this movie, and it's the first one. It's a motorcycle chase. You've seen it in the trailer. And I think for me, why that scene works really well is because young Will and older Will are not really up close and personal in those scenes. You know, it's shot, you know, in a wide open area. It's well lit. You know, they probably use stunt doubles, that sort of thing. And it works because of that. Where it falls apart is when they try to bring them close together. So this is when it gets weird and the body movements are off. It looks like how Neo looked when he was fighting all the agents in the Matrix, or kind of like Blade 2. The body movements are just weird and it's jarring. It jumps out at you know? And then of course the ending, oh my God, it looked like they ran out of money on his face in the ending. It was so jarring. The entire audience I saw this with gasped and then laughed at how bad it looked. I don't know what happened there in the ending. So like I said, it had its moments where you could appreciate the technology behind this, but technology alone doesn't make for a good movie. And like I said in my intro, this is a movie, this is a story we've seen like a dozen times before, 100 times before. Movie with an aging hitman and somebody's out to get him because he's seen as a liability. Maybe he knows too much, maybe he's asking questions he shouldn't be asking, and they send someone after him. You know, we've seen this before, and for me it can work. Like it worked really well. Personally, I love Looper. I thought that worked really well there, because the story was engaging, the acting was really good. Here the acting is not bad, but nobody really has that much to do other than the Will Smith character. Nobody else really has that much. Mary Elizabeth Winstead, she's awesome in everything. I really like her a lot. And I actually think her character here is one of the better developed in the terms of she's also, well, should I get spoilery? Should I get into spoilers? Let's just say she's more than she appears to be. But she handles herself at a level that is believable. She's not like a super, like Anna or like, you know, these killers that seem like nothing can touch them and they just invincible. She handles herself at a believable level in a fight. And I really like that. Benedict Wong, his character, he's comic relief here, really, but it's always fun to see him show up. Clive Owen as a villain is as paper thin as they get. He's a one note, one dimensional villain. You'll feel no sympathy for him. You're supposed to because of something they reveal with him and clone, but it's so paper thin you don't care. And he himself, he doesn't really put anything into it, you know, other than what's on the surface. So you don't really care what happens to him. So overall, guys, Gemini, I mean, like I said, they get points for trying something, but this is something that maybe if it happened 10, 12 years ago, if we saw this movie 10 or 12 years ago, this might have blown people away. Honestly, this would have had an impact. I kind of compare it to Avatar. Avatar is a movie where the story is basically a ripoff of Dances with Wolves and movies like that. And yet, because of the fact that that 3D technology was new to us, when you saw it in cinemas, people remember that movie so fondly and they have this like, oh my God, Avatar was awesome. But Avatar, the story is like, whatever, I've seen this before. You know, even while I was watching it, I was like, this is Dances with Wolves. This is not new to me. But it was so visually appealing that I could put that aside. Here we have another generic action movie with a few bells and whistles, and the bells and whistles are not good enough to carry the story. So for me, this movie is a 5 out of 10. It's a very generic movie. It tries a few things, and who knows, with time and with better technology, especially for the theaters, because I believe this movie was shot at 120 fps frames per second, and you're talking about some movie cinemas that could only show stuff at probably 45 fps. I don't know what IMAX is. So unless you have maybe like a 4K television to watch this on, you might see this in a whole different light. The technology might look better to you, but for everybody else, it's not really going to jump out at you. And the bad stuff is so bad that it's very noticeable. So Gemini Man gets a 5 out of 10. And that's it, guys. So if you like this video, please feel free to hit that thumbs up button. It's very much appreciated. You guys want to subscribe to my channel, you can click on my face right over there, and of course you can ring that notification bell for new videos. I try to put new stuff out every Wednesday, Thursday for the latest, but like I say, work can get crazy sometimes. And this week we have this week we have Maleficent, The Informer, and of course Zombieland Double Tap. So it's gonna be fun to check those out. So until next time, guys, adios.